I'm Pat Mills. I'm the creator of 2000 AD comic, and I'm here to interview the people on Robot Overlords. Well, we knew that there was going to be a science fiction boom. This was just before Star Wars came out. But in terms of what 2000 AD represents, it's actually somewhat different. It's really about ordinary heroes. They may be wearing extraordinary costumes, but they are ordinary people. That sounds maybe a little obscure, but if you look at a lot of heroes and also a lot of authors, their material is often moving towards the middle classes. If you like, I would personally sum it up that 2000 AD began and still remains essentially, to use a rather old-fashioned word, a working-class comic. And that's actually very important to me. There's so many, aren't there? It's difficult because I could say Slane, I could say Nemesis, but I'd probably say Rojors from the series Robusters, and he's a garbage robot with a foul mouth, and he's probably the one I identify with the most. So I guess that's who I am fondest of. Magazines, comics that come out from Britain, there is a certain unwritten resistance in Hollywood. If these characters, Strontium Dog, ABC Warriors, Nemesis, if they come out from Marvel Comics, they would have been made into movies a long, long time ago. And I think that's part of the resistance. There is resistance to comic book characters from other countries. But I think that can't possibly last. You know, we've had two Judge Dredd films. There's constant conversations about various 2000 AD characters being optioned for movies. So some of them have to happen because we've got an entire universe there. I like to be unorthodox, and I think at the end of the day, you've got to ask some hard questions about why didn't it, obviously did better, as I understand it, than the original Judge Dredd, but it didn't do as well as it should have done for there, as I understand it, for there to be a sequel. And there are hard questions to be asked about that, and I'm probably not the person who should ask them, but I mean, it's a point. It's a very important point. It's a nettle that no one wants to grasp. Pleasing the fans is important, which is what the Dredd film did, but it didn't, to be blunt, please enough of the ordinary public. And in my book, they're the ones you start with. And the fans, I'm sorry to say, come a very, very close second. Otherwise, you get into Watchmen territory. The same problem applied to Watchmen. Director did exactly what Watchmen fans wanted. And in fact, many of them actually didn't like it because it was exactly like the book. But you've got to really think of the public. What I think of is, if I was going to do something on ABC Warriors, it's like, supposing no one's ever read it before, they haven't grown up with ABC Warriors, how do I make it appeal to the man or the boy or the girl in the street? And that's my thinking, if you like. Well, I'm personally rather obsessed with digital comics, which in Britain are in the Stone Age. So in response to your question, I'm almost saying, don't get me started, because I really think, whether we like it or not, and I happen to like it, that digital comics are actually a way forward. Now, we may all love paper, and we love the smell of paper and all the rest of it, but if you're a 10-year-old or a 15-year-old kid, either now or later, you're going to be looking at comics on an iPad. So that's the way I'm currently going. I have a digital series out called Requiem. We're up to about volume 8 on Comixology. And I actually like that way of doing things. Even though I adore the smell of paper and I love beautiful books, I'm very much in favor of that. And I think, unfortunately, I think in Britain and perhaps in the States, I'm not so sure, we've got a long, long way to go on digital comics. But if we get it right and we get our audience, I think it could cause a much-needed comic renaissance. Requiem Vampire Night is a digital comic series on Comixology, and it runs to umpteen volumes. I think there's about 7-8 volumes uploaded at the moment. It's the most gorgeous fantasy artwork you have ever seen in your life. It's totally over the top. If you're a goth, if you've got tattoos, if you just like fantasy, there's something there for you in Requiem. How to get into the industry, and the other is how to write. So I'm going to address the second one, which is to write. If you're thinking about writing from the point of view of, reading lots of comics or whatever, I would say that isn't actually the way forward. The first thing to do is either get yourself a guru or get yourself a Bible, a book on writing where there is a guru, and I can recommend one. It's Robert McKee, who wrote a best-selling book called Story, which is aimed at people who want to write movies, but the laws of storytelling are universal and apply to comics. And if anyone absorbs all that information in Robert McKee, and that they will know how to write stories. And that knowledge can be applied in comics, it can be applied in films, it can be applied in novels. So they're not wasting their time with it. The other aspect, how to get into comics, my God, that's a tough one. I think if I was starting today, I wouldn't get in. So their guess is probably as good as mine. 2000 AD continues to grow. There's digital versions of it. Speaking for my own characters, they're still running after, well, far too long. I don't actually like to think about how long. I think it's past the point where you might say, oh, well, it's run out of steam, or, like so many comics have. I mean, it's, 35 years old or something like that? I'm not sure I like to think about exactly how old. It's the standard. It's like Private Eye or any other Mad magazine. It's been around for a long time. It's going to be around forever. And that's particularly pleasing for me because, to get back to my original rant, it's a working class comic. It came from working class roots. It's about working class heroes. That's really important, and that's why it succeeded. It's not full of smug middle class heroes who, I won't point a finger in any direction, but they are out there.